Dito natin nakita na meron talaga tayong butas in two things. Enforcement, na bakit umabot ng 2 taon na umiikot ito sa merkado nationwide bago napansin ng mga officials, and it had to take the social media to bring it into the open. And the second is a lack of legislation. And doon ako papasok bilang isang congressman. Hmm. Dahil isang sa experience nito, gumanda yung connection natin sa Consumer Protection Group, pati yung Fair Trade Bureau ng Department of Trade and Industry. And sila na mismo nagsasabi, Congressman, ito lang talaga yung limitations ng batas. Kulang talaga ng ngipin yung batas at mukhang kailangan ng i-revisit. So this is the first case of annexation by commercial product na nakikita na limited talaga ang ating mga batas. Yung pananagutan ng mga tao dito ay simple lamang. On the part of the on the TTI, the most that they can do is pull out, demand a product pull out from all shelves throughout the Philippines and all online platforms. The second is the FDA. The most that they can do is a cancellation of their license to operate. The third, on the LGU side, not just the City of Manila, it is the cancellation of the privilege to do business in the City of Manila. So hindi ika-cancel na ang kanilang mga business permits. And then on the private side, like the online selling platforms ng Lazada, ng Shopee, that's already self-governing. Sila na mismo nag-voluntary na pull out.
Oh, so, pero Congressman,
nothing in the law that calls for imprisonment on these violations. On immigration law, the most is, as according to Mayor Isko Moreno, pwedeng undesirable alien and move for deportation, maybe declaration of persona non grata. But there is no specific law that goes against this.